have come into this house to gather in his name and worship Christ our Lord. Worship him, concentrate on him and worship him. So forget about yourself and concentrate on him and worship him. So
we gather to celebrate the 25th Sunday in ordinary time. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
Let us put ourselves before God's mercy and compassion. Lord Jesus, you come to heal our broken hearts. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come to give forgiveness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come to guide us by your Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Father,
And let us pray. O God, who founded all the commandments on your sacred law, upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts we may attain eternal life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Hear this, you that trample on the needy and bring to ruin the poor of the land, saying, when will the new moon be over so that we may sell grain, and the Sabbath so that we may offer wheat for sale? We will measure out less and charge more, and tamper with the scales, buying the poor for silver and the needy for a pair of sandals, and selling the sweepings of the wheat. The Lord has sworn by the pride of Jacob, saying, surely I will never forget any of their deeds. Brothers and sisters, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise the Lord. Ooh, lift up the poor. Alleluia. Praise the Lord. Ooh, lift up the poor.
reading from the first letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I urge that supplications, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgivings be made for everyone, for kings and all who are in high positions, so that we may lead a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and dignity. This is right and is acceptable in the sight of God our Savior, who desires everyone to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. For there is one God, there is also one mediator between God and the human race, the man Christ Jesus, who gave himself a ransom for all. This was attested at the right time. For this I was appointed a herald and an apostle, a teacher of the Gentiles in faith and truth. I am telling the truth. I'm not lying. My brothers and sisters, the word of the Lord.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the disciples, there was a rich man who had a manager, and charges were brought to him that the manager was squandering his property. So the rich man summoned him and said, what is this I hear about you? Give me an account of your management, because you cannot be my manager any longer. Then the manager said to himself, what will I do now that my master is taking the position away from me? I'm not strong enough to dig. I'm ashamed to beg. I have devised what to do so that when I am dismissed as manager, people will welcome me into their homes. So summoning his manager's debtors, one by one, he asked the first, how much do you owe my master? He answered, 100 jugs of olive oil. He said to him, take your bill, sit down quickly, and make it 50. Then he asked another, how much do you owe? He replied, 100 containers of wheat. He said to him, take your bill and make it 80. And his master commended the dishonest manager because he had acted shrewdly. For the children of this age are more shrewd in dealing with their own generation than the children of light. And I tell you, make friends for yourself by means of dishonest wealth, so that when it is gone, they may welcome you into the eternal homes. Whoever is faithful in very little is faithful in much. And whoever is dishonest in very little is dishonest in much. And if you have not been faithful with the dishonest wealth, who will entrust you with true riches? And if you are not faithful with what belongs to another, who will give you what is your own? No slave can serve two masters, for a slave will either hate one and love the other, or be devoted to one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and wealth. My brothers and sisters, our salvation, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today's gospel sounds a little strange to our ears. Why is it that Jesus is raising up this less than honest manager as kind of the hero of the story? Let's look at the context. The way that people would have heard it in Jesus' time was very different. So the background is that it was against the law for Jews to go and charge interest when they loaned something to someone else. So the rich people found a way around it. Just like today, rich people find a way to keep getting rich and the rest of folks don't get rich. So what they did is they would, the guy who gets the 80 jugs of oil, he's told to put on his invoice 100, so he had to pay back 100 jugs of oil. The guy who gets 50 containers or bushels of wheat is told to put 100, so he has to pay back 100. And so what the manager was smart enough to go, and that's that would go against the Jewish law of the day. So the manager said to each of these merchants, take your invoice and put down exactly what you got. 80 jugs of oil and 50 containers or bushels of wheat. And by doing so, it became public later on that the manager was getting fired. And they'll say, what'd you do? And he says, well, I didn't do anything wrong. I actually helped my boss, the rich guy, go and obey the Jewish law. So that's kind of the context. So it sounds different when you get the scriptural background of context as opposed to, you know, why is Jesus choosing this guy to be the hero of the story? It's really about how that this manager decides, okay, if I'm going to get fired, I at least want to make some friends. I'm going to do the right thing, if nothing else, to help me, but also to help them. But scripture reading is basically today about stewardship. How are we good stewards of what God gives us, our time, our treasure, our talent? This weekend and next weekend, we celebrate my 30th anniversary as pastor here at St. Martin's and Deacon Bobby's 25th anniversary of ordination. Deacon Bobby's been here with us about 16 years as our deacon, thank God. And both of us do is try to be good stewards of what we've been given. So over the 30 years I've been here, I've learned a whole lot I never was taught in seminary about. I replaced four roofs, because we have four buildings, the rectory, the church, the community center, and the school, four heating systems, four AC unit systems, a whole bunch of plumbing, a whole lot of toilets, and the list goes on. Stuff they never taught us in seminary, along with learning how to go and basically help us to get from, when I first came, we were barely able to pay our bills, to how now that we are able to do that and have money to help in more outreach programs. And so my goal is how that we choose, for instance, like we don't have a full-time secretary, I figured, we could do this, we'll find a way to do it with a part-time secretary. I don't have a housekeeper, I work cheap. I do my own cooking, my own laundry, I clean the house once in a while. Now, that saves us money we can use for other, to me, important things like helping to give people housing and food and rent and utilities and all those basics that folks need. So to me, it's how we as a community are good stewards. A really practical example of this is when the pandemic started a little more than 2 years ago, over half of the parishes in the Archdiocese, their income dropped by 50%. It stayed below 50% for probably a year and a half to 2 years. At St. Martin's, our income never dropped. And that's, I heard someone in the diocese once saying to me, so like, Michael, how do you guys do that? I said, we take stewardship important. We take tithing. We take seriously supporting St. Martin's and all of our ministries. And we know the money we give does more than just keep the lights on, but it helps a lot of people in need. And we all know how many extra people were in need during the pandemic. So I'm really proud of that. And I often boast about that to some other priests saying, you know, St. Martin's has continued to do its part. But we do it not just as a church community, but we do it individually in our own lives also. And it's not just money. It's how we've used our talent to put together this mass that you're now seeing on YouTube. How we found ways for our music people to continue to do their part when they're home so we can get all this glued together and comes out every Saturday night. So it takes a lot of people behind the scenes that you never see to make this mass happen. To me, that's a wonderful example of the stewardship of St. Martin's, where we have lots of people who use their talents to go and make something very special happen for all of you who are with us praying this day. And you know, I just encourage all those who have yet to choose to be part of the stewardship process here at St. Martin's to make a decision to do something. I get envelopes. I put $30 a week in my envelope, which is 5% of my income. And to me, that's important. Why would I ask other people to go and support St. Martin's if I don't support St. Martin's? So I just encourage those who've yet to get on board, so to speak, to decide to come and join us in some way, because all of us together sharing our little gifts and talents and treasure make this work. St. Martin's is blessed because we've chosen to be good stewards. And we've chosen to give God thanks and praise for all the ways that God continues to bless us with time and our talents and all the wisdom and strength and treasure we have. May we, this week, as we celebrate our anniversaries here for hanging out here at St. Martin's, to thank God for all the ways that God has blessed us as a community and how God personally has blessed me that I still get to hang out here as pastor. So I feel very, very honored to be the pastor of St. Martin's. I know Deacon Bobby's very honored to be here as deacon. And together, we help to bring together all of your gifts so that we collectively can be good stewards of all that God gives. God blesses us in so many ways. May we continue to share God's blessing with those in need. Amen. I invite you to pray with me the creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, and through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds in the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, life of the world to come. Amen. Let us present to the Lord our needs, the needs of our larger community. For all those who have died, especially for Odessa Weaver, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our families and students and teachers as they begin the new school year, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of Ukraine, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
I invite you to lift up your own needs and concerns. Lord God, we lift up to you these and all those needs that weigh in our hearts. We make them known through your Son, Jesus, who lives with us and through us now and forever. Amen. So we prepare the altar again. I thank you for your support. My mail update is we actually got mail every day this week. It's like a miracle. But here again, your generosity helps us to be generous to many folks in need. Lord God, we ask that you bless this bread and this wine, fruit of the field and fruit of the vine, so it soon becomes the very body and blood of Jesus. Blessed be God forever. Receive with favor, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be ours through heavenly blessings. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed us in your own image and set us over the whole world in all its wonder to rule in your name over all that you've made and forever praise you in your mighty works through your Son, Jesus. We join all the angels as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit, that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed, entered the world into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation. Give you thanks you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Wilton, our Bishop, and all of the women and men who lead and guide the Church. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who've died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, Martin, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ, through him, with him, in him. O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray for the fullness of God's kingdom as we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Give you peace. My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever." May the peace of the Lord be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
And for those who are so blessed to have others with you, I invite you to share a sign of the Lord's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. I invite you to ask the risen Lord spiritually to give you that strength and wisdom and grace to be able to be good stewards of all that God blesses you with. This is the body of Christ. And let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with the sacrament, that we may continue to be strengthened to build your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite you to pray with me our family prayer for justice and human dignity, crafted by Cardinal Gregory and the bishops of our diocese. Loving and faithful God, we come to you, Father, to ask that through your Son, Jesus, in a communion with the Holy Spirit, you help us in the battle against America's original sin of racism that divides us from being the body of Christ that we are called to be as your children. We implore you to give us your wisdom so that we may build a community founded on the gospel message, the life and dignity of all people from the womb to the tomb, and to live in communion like the divine communion of the Holy Trinity. Bless parents that they may form their children of faith to love one another, regardless of skin color, ethnicity, and national origin, just as Jesus loves us. Bless and protect all of us as we live out our faith and be instruments of your peace, as St. Francis said. Fill us with a thirst for justice and righteousness. Hear our prayer. Give us the courage, compassion, and perseverance to root out any form of injustice within our communities and to bring the healing love of Christ to all in need. Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of our Church, hasten to help us and intercede on our behalf so that our archdiocese can continue to witness to the gospel message of life and dignity of all people. Amen. Our announcements. This coming Sunday, we have the medical students from Georgetown University coming for the first visit this year. They'll be here on Sunday mornings, actually Sunday afternoons, right after the 12 o'clock Mass, about 1 o'clock. And they will begin doing blood pressures on this visit. There's a few of their visits will be virtual, and the rest will be in person. So we will get the schedule. It'll be listed in the bulletin as we go along, and we'll also make announcements. But we're really excited to have the new crop of Georgetown medical students. They've been coming here to St. Martin's now for over 20 years. It's a great opportunity for them and for us to have them with us. This coming Sunday, we have our anniversary dinner to celebrate my anniversary, Bobby's anniversary. It'll be 6 o'clock over Gallaudet, $75. I think we still have some tickets left, so if you know someone who wants to come, they need to let us know, like, very, very quickly. Next Sunday, which is the last Sunday of September, on the 25th of September, we have Cardinal Gregory coming for his very first time to St. Martin's to celebrate my 30th anniversary as pastor and Deacon Bobby's 25th anniversary of being ordained as a deacon. So that's a real special event for us. So that Mass will be live streamed. If you want to join us on the Sunday, the 12 noon, that'll be live streamed, so you can join us that way. It won't be on this YouTube Mass. Sunday school begins this coming weekend, so in the email blast that you received this Mass today, below it you'll see a sentence talking about Sunday school begins. If you click on there, there'll be stuff to register your children. Sunday school actually be the first class is the first Sunday in October the 2nd. And you can tell the people if they want to come to join us, they're welcome to. Our parish council meets this coming Tuesday, September 20th at 7 p.m. and it's a virtual. NOVA continues in the show The Color Purple over Second Street Theater through October the 9th. If you haven't seen it, it's a wonderful, wonderful show. And Daniel, who's our director for our traditional choir, is doing a musical theater program, a gospel musical actually, called Roll On. It begins in October. There'll be information in the bulletin about that, where it is down at the Ark in Southeast DC. A few of you know that Miss Odessa Weaver passed. She was in her 90s. Her funeral will be on September 27th here at St. Martin's at 11 o'clock. And I don't have any birthdays down here, but I'm sure that someone will tell me this later on. But if it's your birthday coming up, happy birthday. That's all the announcements. Let us pray for God's blessing. May the Lord continue to strengthen us and guide us so that we can use our time, our treasure, and our talent to be good managers of all that God entrusts us to and to build God's kingdom of justice. Let the church say,
Amen.
May the Lord give blessing in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Amen.